Hi there, welcome to What Jesus Would Think. I have no idea what Jesus would think. But I want you all to know that these videos are not very easy for me to do. Be in front of the camera. I read Proverbs today to my daughter before she went to bed. And I thought it was pretty interesting, some of the things in Proverbs, one of my very favorite books. It says right here in chapter 1, and I don't know how far I read down what this video is going to be about tonight, but it says in chapter 1, the Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel, to know wisdom and instruction, to preserve the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice, and judgment and equality, to give subtlety to simple, to the young man knowledge and direction. A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. To understand a proverb and the interpretation of the words and the wise and their dark sayings. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instructions of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother, for they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about the neck. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. If they say, come with us, and let us lay and wait for blood, let us lurk privately for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them alive as the grave, and whole as those that go down into the pit. We shall find all precious substances. We shall fill our houses with spoil. Cast in thy lot among us. Let us all have one purse. My son, walk not thy in thy way with them. Refrain thy foot from their path, for their feet run to evil and make haste to shed blood. Surely in vain the net is spread in the sight of any bird, and they lay wait for their own blood. They lurk privately for their own lives. So are the ways of everyone that is greedy of gain, which taketh away the life of the owners thereof. Wisdom cometh without the others. She utters her voice in the streets. And that was chapter 1 all the way down to, or chapter 1 verse 1 all the way down to verse 20. Want you all to know that I've had dyslexia all my life too. So it's hard for me to read sometimes. It's not easy for me to make these videos and open up like this. Most of my life, I've every abuse possible known to man that I think of, physical, mental, sexual, you name it, I've been through it. I'd been through, I lived in Cheyenne, Wyoming for 10 years of my life. The 10th year we moved down to, moved up to the Minot Air Force Base. And on the Minot Air Force Base, my dad remarried to another lady, same name as my mother. And, she was abusive. And, treated my brother and I like crap, and treated Her kids, like, they were good, but anyways, it's the past. Hard for me to dig. I don't live in that past anymore, but I just felt like I need to tell you a little bit more about myself for some reason tonight. So I moved up on the Minot Air Force Base. I was about 10, 11, 12. About 11 and a half is, I think, when she met her. And then we moved down to not Minot, but the city next to it. I think it was Burlington? Yeah, Burlington, North Dakota. I lived down there for a little bit, and then we moved back on the Minot Air Force Base. And then from there, long story there, went to California for a while. Long story there, but anyways, through board and cures and group homes and stuff, my dad was in my life for about maybe 13 and a half years altogether. And my mother was only in my life for like 2 years. I finally got to meet her. And then I was on my own, basically, from 16. I was in group homes, boarding cares, hospitals, you name it. Go into more depth detail of that. Didn't get out of those places until I was 21. I figured might as well be talking to myself. Don't feel like anybody's really watching these videos, or anybody really cares. My dad told me one time, it's like 90% of people are like happy that you have the problems that you have, and the other 10% are glad you actually have them, or don't care that you have them, I mean. So, I mean, I beg to differ there, but I like to think that there's like that 1% that actually give a rat's rear end. Excuse my French, or my words, I mean there. But anyways, haven't made a video in a while. I was thinking about maybe just ending it, almost deleted my account. But the Lord inside me wouldn't let me do that, so I filled up to it to make another video tonight, even though I didn't even want to. It was more the Lord compelling me to. I went down to the FOTM, and I have to say that that man, Doug, made me feel smaller than, like, I was nothing, really. Probably just my own self, but didn't make me feel like I was much of anything. I don't know why I felt that way. But anyways, I seriously doubt that he's going to show any of my videos on his websites or anything. But I'm still care about the man, still prayed about his ministry. Or maybe I went out there and I don't know. It was just definitely not what I expected. Just see a lot of caring brothers, a lot of caring sisters, and all of them really giving 100%, caring. I never seen more love in my life down there in that one place for people. They seem to genuinely care about people, I have great respect for Doug and Cindy, but I don't think they know that. But anyways, I thought I would come on here and just make another video. Hopefully Proverbs helps out. I always thought Proverbs is a very important book. I always felt the Lord speak to me personally in that. I have to honestly say, through all the stuff that I've been through, it was the Lord that helped me not become, the opposite of who I am now. My wife got into a little bit of psychology, psychiatry there in school and stuff, and she says, everything that's happened to me, I totally defy the laws of that, you hear of these other other people like Charles Manson and Ted Bundy and just a little bit of bad stuff that happened to them. Well, I've gone through a whole lot freaking worse than those guys, and I haven't turned freaking that bad. You know, I can honestly say I haven't gone out of my way ever to hurt anybody. Even no matter how mad I've been, I've always taken things out on myself. Funny how that works. Didn't want to become like those other people that treated me that way, so I thought, you know, well, I'll break something instead, or just a random object, or talk down to myself. But, I don't know. Probably gonna take forever to download this thing. The longer the video is, the longer this small little computer has a chance to upload it. And these videos aren't as grand as some of the other ones out there. I mean, a lot of people know how to speak a lot better than I do, but I know how to say things and big words and music and the whole nine yards on their videos, but I don't know, I threw some of my artwork out there. Got one comment so far. I basically felt alone all my life. Basically, a lot of people just drop the ball on me, you know. Realize it's just me and Jesus, then. You know, had to figure out things on my own. Started work when I was 16. I worked at a Western Eagle High School. I became the president of my high school. It's a private high school called North Valley Raptors at the time. I became the president there. And then I worked at the school shop there. I dealt with money and gave it to the teachers, you know, change. I forgot what you call them, clerisy clerk or whatnot. And then after school, I had walked across the street and worked for Western Angels Foundation, the place where you load food on trucks and the trucks bring it to the poor and the churches. Did that for a while. Got my high school diploma. Really didn't know what the heck I wanted to do with my life. I thought, you know, being an artist, since I had the talent, would be good. And I thought everything, you know, saw everything coming out on paper first would, you know, so if it comes out on paper, that must be where the money is. So I would draw, you know, and then watch things come into life. But I was never really too good with math, so being an architect was out of the question. About commercial art, but I didn't want to do commercial designs for a place that's going to be corrupt, you know. So I don't know, I'm just a private artist. I just a lone wolf artist of some kind. I just draw for whatever anybody wants a design of anything. I just draw it. No, I try to stay away from the darker drawings, skulls and stuff like that. Drew one another day with skulls and wings and stuff, but has its own little interpretation to it to me. As Jesus defeated death, I like to look at death as a friend that reminds me to, take advantage of every opportunity I got before it's gone. You know, just a friend that reminds me to enjoy everything I got before it's gone. You know, it's a better way to look at him. Although I can't stand him. It's the opposite of life. But anyways, hope this video helps. No one wants to talk about it. I don't want to make it too long because it seems like a lot of people out there can't stand watching a 5-minute or even 15-minute video or 20-minute video unless they have some kind of substance. I guess. I don't know. Hope the speakers are loud enough to hear you. Well, hear me, I mean. Oh. Anyways, this is a little website called What Would Jesus Think? Trying to make people just, before they do something, maybe pop in your mind, what would Jesus think about that before you do it? That's about it. So, peace, love, God bless.